Okay, guys, let's move to change to a subject of formula. Change to subject of formula. So now we are given A is equals to 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h, and they want us to make h a subject. So, to make h a subject, h is lying here at 2 pi r h. So, we need to get rid of this one. So, what we're going to do, we want to solve for h. So, first of all, let's remove 2 pi r squared. When we remove it, we get rid of it by crossing it an equal sign. So if 2 pi r squared comes, this side is going to be negative. So it's going to be a minus 2 pi r squared is equals to 2 pi r h. So remember, we are solving for h. We must make h a subject. So in this case, what does it mean? It means we need to divide both sides with the variables that are next to h. Like in our situation, 2 pi r, these variables are next to h. So we need to divide both sides using 2 pi r. Even this side you divide using 2 pi r. And then 2 pi r and 2 pi r cancel this side. So now h is equals to a minus 2 pi r squared divided by 2 pi r. So this is how we make h a subject of formula. So remember, we want, or our focus is on making h a subject of formula. We're not solving here, we're not simplifying. So you don't have to cancel 2 and 2 pi and pi. No, these ones will remain the same, so long h is now a subject. Okay, let's move to this question. S is equals to p bracket 1 plus rt, and they're asking you to make t a subject of formula. So t is inside the bracket. So first thing first, we need to clear the brackets. So how do you clear the brackets? We multiply everything using p that is inside the bracket. So we're gonna say s is equals to, and then p times 1 is gonna be p plus p times rt is gonna be p rt. This is how it operates. So our t is lying here inside PRT. So let's remove this P. And then if this P cross the equal sign, is gonna be negative. So it's gonna be S minus P is equals to PRT. And then once you left with PRT and you are very aware that you are looking for T, and you're gonna come and be like, what are the values that are attached to your subject? So PR are the values that are attached to your subject. So you're gonna have to divide both sides using the values that are attached with T. We're looking for T, so we'll divide both sides with PR, divide both sides with PR. And then we're gonna cancel PR and PR. So T is equals to S minus P divided by PR. So this is how we do it. Okay, so in other words, you can calculate it like this. Once you get at stage number 3, you like S minus P is equals to PRT. So instead of dividing both sides using PR, you divide all the variable using PR. So even here we divide using PR, even here we divide using PR. So PR and PR will cancel. So T will be equals to S divided by PR, S over PR minus P and P, they can cancel here. So it's gonna be one. Here it's gonna be one. So it's gonna be divided by one over R is equals to, yeah, this will be another answer. So we have two ways of calculating. This can be the answer, or this one can also be the answer. Okay, let's move to the last one. Interest is equals to principal rate times time. So now what we're going to do here, they're asking you to make T a subject of formula, and your T is lying here at PRT. So PRT, remember, is a shorthand of P times R times T. So if the subject that you're looking for is within these products, or these multiples of P and R and T, what are you supposed to do? Just know that you divide both sides with the unwanted. So the unwanted is PR. So we're gonna have to divide both sides using PR, because PR is our unwanted. So this side, PR and PR cancels, okay? Once they cancel, you'll be like T is equals to I over PR. So this is how we do it, okay? Now let's come back to this formula here. Area of triangle is equals to half of base times height. So in short, we can say area of triangle is equals to BH over 2. B times height is like BH, okay? Half of, so it means you divide them by 2. So they're asking you to make H a subject of formula. So in this case, to make H a subject of formula, since we have BH over 2, it means we have a fraction. So first of all, get rid of the fraction. And to get rid of the fraction, you must multiply all the variables using the denominator. So here you will multiply using the denominator 2. Also here we'll multiply using the denominator 2. So 2 times a is gonna be 2a is equals to 2, and 2 here will cancel. So 2a is equals to bh, and then your h is here at b, and b is the unwanted. So the unwanted, remember, divide both sides. So you cancel this side, you cancel this side using b. So h is equals to 2a over b. So h is equals to 2a over b. So that will be your answer, okay? Let's move to this other question here. So remember, they're asking you to calculate or to make C a subject of formula, and we have a fraction where we have this denominator 5. So what must we do in this case? So first thing first, remove the fraction by multiplying all the variables using the denominator 5. So this side you multiply using 5, and then here you also multiply using 5, and here you also multiply using 5. Okay, 5 times f is gonna be how much? 5f is equals to 5, and 5 will cancel. You will remain with 9c plus 32 times 5 will give you 160. So this is what you're going to remain with. And then what are you calculating for? You're calculating for c. You want to make c a subject. So get rid of this positive 160, and you take it and you bring it the other side of equal sign. So when you bring it the other side of equal sign, it's gonna be negative. So you can say 5f minus 160 is equals to 9c. So here's the thing. We are looking for c, and 9c is the shorthand of 9 times c. So it means our c is under multiplication. So when we are dealing with the multiplication variables, what must we do? We divide both sides using the unwanted, and in this case our unwanted is 9, so we're gonna have to divide both sides using 9. So let's divide using 9, let's divide using 9. Okay, so 9 and 9 will cancel. You will be like c is equals to 5f over 9 minus 160 over 9. So this will be your answer. You see, it's a subject of formula now. Okay, so this is how we do everything. This is how we do everything. Okay, one more thing, let's do this question here. P is equals to m squared minus x over 2, and they're asking you to calculate for x. So they want you to make x a subject. So first of all, look, we have a fraction here, x over 2. So first thing first, we get rid of the fraction by multiplying all the variables using the denominator of the fraction. And in this case, the denominator of the fraction is 2. So we're gonna have to multiply using 2. We also multiply here using 2. We also multiply p using 2. So 2 times p is gonna be 2p is equals to 2 times m squared is gonna be 2m squared. And then 2 times x divided by 2, 2 and 2 will divide each other, so you will remain with negative x. So remember, we are solving for x. So let's make this x a positive x, okay? And then to make it a positive x, we need to take it and bring it the other side of an equal sign so that it will change from negative to positive. So I'll take this negative x and bring it here. So it's gonna be positive x is equals to 2m squared. And then I take 2p and then bring the other side of equal sign. So it's gonna be negative when it comes this side. So this will be your answer. Okay. So this is how we do the subject of formulas. Thank you.